Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make your very own floating window in the original version of Sketchware. And so, please make sure to watch the whole video so you don't miss out on any logic. So, let's get started. Today I have two buttons with me. One is check permission, which checks if the app has been granted permission by the device to execute the window. The second button just below check permission will help us show the window and also take the floating process in the background. If we take a closer look here, we see that this code is used to create the floating window, but from a custom view named custom. This custom view contains a linear and a button as defined here. Like any other, this code lets you customly set the window's width and height. Probably the best place to set both the window's width and height is on activity create. Since all widgets vary in size depending on many different screen sizes, we'll use the math block, get, dip. We once did tutorials on this channel that covered all math blocks and how they're used. Follow the math block tutorial and many others on the link card above. From here, set any values that you think all devices require. This code, as many know, is used to take any processes in background. But, once the app is closed, our floating button will also close. So, to solve it, just go to events, then on destroy activity event. And drag the move to task more block. Set this more block to boolean true. Once you do this, there's no need to worry about this problem anymore. Your floating window will show anytime anywhere you set it to. There's only one more thing left for us to do. We need to go to an app that will let us edit the project's Android manifest. But first, we need to know the project's ID. To do this, just add anything inappropriate to a code on any part of the project, so that the compile log shows. Be careful though. You don't want to change anything you can't unchange, so make it simple. .1051 is our project ID. We'll use this in XML Editor Pro to identify our project. So now, let us open the app I've been talking too much about. Once you've opened the app, locate to Manual Manager. Select the floating window project. Then click on Editor Studio. It will ask for you to compile the project for capture. After hitting the Run button on Sketchware, the XML Editor application will open a new editing activity automatically. Next, look for Uses Permission section. If there isn't, paste this code near the top. This code is on the description below. Next, click Save and tap on the arrow icon. Go back to Sketchware and compile the project once more. On the compiling process, you'll see a toast message that says, "Successfully installed." Once installation is done, the app will first ask for permission from the device. Click on Show Floating Window. You can drag the button freely anywhere on the screen, and even click it as many times, without it even collapsing. And, finally, success! I hope you learned and enjoyed today's tutorial. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.